My email disappeared while composing. Can I get it back? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's the question. I was responding to an email, but my response disappeared. Do you know a way I can get it back? First, do Ctrl Z. Before you do anything else, just do Ctrl Z. I'll explain why in a moment, but that's like the very first thing you should try before you do anything else, because many of the anything else's could make that Ctrl Z not work. So this is something that happens a lot. It's really not at all uncommon for email to be in the process of being written. And it doesn't matter whether you're using an email program or a word processor even, or you're doing it on a website, stuff happens. There are some things that are more common than others, and I'm actually going to show you one of the more common scenarios. But there are simply things that happen, which mean then that there are places to look. So let's flip over here to an email that's already in composition that I've actually started writing. You can see it's a very lengthy, very important email that I'm working on. And all of a sudden, for no apparent reason, it disappears. What happened, right? We don't know what happened. Especially if you are a touch typist or kind of a half touch typist, and you're not actually looking at the screen or you're looking at the keyboard or you're just looking away, it's very easy not to realize what just happened. What literally just happened is I typed very quickly Ctrl A and then the Enter key. Ctrl A means select everything. And then whatever you type next replaces that everything. That's why I suggest first thing to try is Ctrl Z. Ctrl Z brought it all back. Ctrl Z is the keyboard shortcut for undo. The single most common reason email disappears while composing is that you accidentally selected more than you thought. In some cases, it's really easy to do it simply by accidentally typing Ctrl A, and then without noticing, you kept on typing, replacing everything that had been selected. Ctrl Z brings it back. Now, there are some other things to look for. For example, here's my message. It is, as I said, it's in composition. If I close it, it'll actually let me save it in drafts or not. There are scenarios where switching away from that window or closing that window, or especially in online email, opening a different browser window or navigating to a different email message, it will automatically save whatever you're working on in the drafts folder. Now here in Thunderbird, of course, it's pretty obvious. There's the drafts folder and there's the message that I was working on. I can simply double click on it to bring it back up, and I can then continue composing the message and send it on its way. Definitely, after you've tried Ctrl Z, look at or look for the drafts folder in whatever email program or interface you're using. The last straw that I'm going to throw out for you to grasp at, it's not going to work as often, but it is something to at least try, and that is simply close your email program or close your browser and then open them up again. Go back to where you were. Go back to the drafts folder. See if something reappeared that seems to have disappeared or looks to have disappeared at some point in the past. Those are the three things that I suggest you try in order. Ctrl Z, undo, the drafts folder, just in case, and then closing the program, again, really just in case. Now, the other thing that I suggest you get into the habit of, and this is more of a preventative measure than it is anything else, is to periodically save your work in progress. There's an old joke that you can tell how experienced a computer programmer or a computer user is by how often they save their work in progress. If you watch me typing a Word document, for example, you'll see every so often I'm just hitting Ctrl S, hitting Ctrl S. I'm just saying, save this to disk, save this to disk, because at some point in my past, it disappeared and I couldn't get it back. Whereas saving to disk allows me to save to the file that I'm working on, whatever it is I'm working on. So the equivalent here, do the Ctrl S, and that just saves it to your draft folder. If you're working with a web-based email system, there may be a different keystroke, or there may not be a keystroke at all, but it is something to be aware of. Saving your work in progress to avoid this problem, or to at least minimize the damage resulting from unexpected loss, is something that is well worth getting into the habit of. And finally, since I know that some folks are kind of curious as to where the heck I came up with this text, it looks like lorem ipsum, but it's not. There's a site that I prefer to use called Bacon Ipsum, and it is a kind of a spoof on lorem ipsum that just turns everything into meat. So there are some more details in the companion article for this video. I strongly suggest you have a look, a couple more straws to grasp at. A little more geeky, but they are things that you might look for. This is all at askleo.com/2630. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.